Welcome back to Synth Breakdown. Today, we're looking at part two of the Terrible Lie discussion of this lead kind of woodblocky, airy sound. Since the previous episode, a great amount of discussion has brought me back to look at the history of the track to see if I can get a bit more technical and understand the workflow of Pre-8 Machine as a whole. So to refamiliarize ourselves and to get a clearer look, let's listen to the empathetic mix of the song, where the mix is much more stripped back. Starting Your Journey is an interview that Trent Reznor did with Keyboard Magazine in 1990. Here we get a great detail of information about the tools and processes used on that album, including the exact sound we are reaching for. Regarding this sound, Trent said, "That sound has a quite an interesting history. It started out as a woodblock, ran it through a distortion pedal, sampled it, then did my Emacs trick by dropping it down a couple of octaves, then I chopped off the beginning of it. I might also have put an envelope on it with turbo synth. That's probably my favorite sound on the record." There are a few things to break down in the statement, starting with the woodblock sound. I couldn't just get any old woodblock sound, because there's such a variety across time and space. I looked through the interview further to find some leads. He mentioned specifically getting the EMU Emacs sampling keyboard. I feel like this is our source. Unfortunately, I couldn't verify that this was the keyboard he used for drum sounds, and I couldn't find any VSTs for the keyboard either. At least anything under $100. But I did find this drum demo, which demonstrates its woodblock sound. I wasn't convinced that this was our sample source until I heard a very familiar sound in another part of the same demo. Okay, now we're sure that this is a primary source of drum sounds, but I can't seem to extract the woodblock. I could crop it out, but that's messy and would contain background noise. So I opted to scour the internet for a sound-alike, because at least now I know what I'm aiming for, and I think I found something pretty close. Next step is the processing. In comparison, this is the easy part. I took the sound and distorted it with Ableton's pedal effect, which should replicate any kind of guitar distortion that Trent might have used. Then I threw it into a sampler, which could be dropped a few octaves. This would recreate that quote-unquote Emacs trick. I used the sampler to cut off the beginning and added a slight bit crash just for flavor. And I think already we are so much closer than before. Now you might also notice there was a turbo synth mentioned. I'm not going to bring this up now because that is a whole other world of exploration. But we'll get there. But for the time being, I think that was an incredibly fun journey, and I hope you enjoyed that process with me. Thanks for watching.